The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on December 6, 1972, in Ahmedabad, India.
Now, in the first chapter of the Bhagavad Gita, it is the setup. Krishna and Arjuna, according to the order of Krishna and Arjuna, Krishna placed the chariot in between the two soldiers, two flanks of soldiers. Senaya rubhayar madhye ratasthapaya me achyuta. Arjuna was respectful to Krishna. Krishna has accepted to be charioteer, inferior position than Krishna. Krishna is on the chariot, sitting on the throne, and Arjuna is sitting on the throne, and Krishna has taken the inferior position, driving the chariot. So, this is very nice position for devotional service. Those who are not devotees, they aspire to become Krishna. Their aspiration is to merge into the existence of the Supreme, or to become one with Krishna. But in devotional service, it is not the desire of the devotee to become one with Krishna, but sometimes to make Krishna as the order carrier of the devotee. To become one with Krishna, it may be a very great position, but to become the, commander of Krishna, that is another thing. That position is greater than to become one with Krishna. So, there are five kinds of liberation. Sajujya. The first liberation is supposed to be sajujya, means to become one with the Supreme. The Mayavad philosopher, monist, they aspire after sajujya mukti. But the devotees, Vaishnavas, they do not aspire after sajujya mukti. For them there are other four kinds of mukti. Sarupa, salukya, shasti, samip. And those who are still further advanced, they do not want any kind of mukti. Neither of these five kinds of mukti. Just like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he prays, na dhanang na janang na sundaring kavitang ba jagadisha kaman. This is pure devotional prayer. The devotee does not approach the Supreme for any material gain. That pure devotion means without any aspiration of any kind of material gain or even spiritual gain. Anna vilasita sunnam jnana karmad anabritam anukullena krishnanu silanam bhakti uttama. Uttama bhakti, first class bhakti. What is that? Anna vilasita sunnam. without any kind of desire than to serve the Lord. And in the Srimad Bhagavatam also it is said, Sabhi Punsang Paro Dharma. Paro means transcendental. Beyond this material conception, Krishna or the Absolute, Narayana, that is Paro, Narayana Paro of Bhaktya. Narayana is not anything of this material world. Narayan, Krishna, Vishnu, the Absolute Personality of Godhead, He is not anything of this material world. When we use this word Niraka, that means His form is not anything of this material world. But He has got His form. That is, transcendental form, Satchidananda Vigraha. Nirakar means he has no such form as we have got this material form. This material form is neither of the three transcendental bliss, Satchit Ananda. This is Asat, Achit, and Nirananda. This body, this material body, is Asat, Achit, and Nirananda. Therefore, when in the Vedic literature or an authorized statement we find Nirakar, that means his form does not belong to this Asat, Achit, or Nirananda. But he has his form. Dibyam, janma karma me dibyam. Dibyam, transcendent. And Sripad Shankaracharya also, who especially preached impersonalism, he also admits the Narayana para of Bhaktat. Narayana, the form of Narayana, is beyond the range of this abhakta, abhakta, and this world is creation, abhaktyat anna sambhava. This world is creation of this abhakta. And beyond this abhakta, there is another nature, that is spiritual nature. That is explained in the Bhagavad Gita. Parastasmat tu bhava anya. Bhakta bhaktyat sanatam. This situation, Krishna is advising, Arjuna advising Rathasthapayame Achyuta. Achyuta, Krishna is not Chyuta. Krishna is Achyuta. Chyuta means those who are fallen in the material world. They are Chyuta. We are fallen in the material world. Therefore, we have accepted this material body. Iccha desa samuthena sarge janti parantapa. Iccha. Iccha means desire, and desa means envy, enviousness. Iccha desa samuthena. When we become envious of Krishna and we want to enjoy this material world, then we come to this material creation. Iccha desa samuthena sarge janti paranta. So, any one of us who is in this material world, having a material body, beginning from Brahma down to the ant, a small ant, any one of them, in the Brahma Sangita it is said, the Jastindra Gopa Mathavendra Maho Sakarma Bandhana Rupa Phalabhajana Matanoti. Indra Gopa, there is an insect which is called in Sanskrit language as Indra Gopa. It is micro. You cannot see with this naked eyes. So this microbe is called Indra, and there is another Indra, the king of him. So the Brahma Sangha is just to Indra Gopa and Mahendra, the king of heaven. Beginning from this Indra Gopa up to the king of heaven, everyone is subjected to enjoy or suffer the resultant action of his karma. By karma, by resultant action of karma, one has become the king of heaven, and by similarly, this by karma, resultant action of karma, one has become the microbe insect. This is the material world. There are 8,400,000 types or forms of this material body, and we are wandering sarvagata in different planets and different forms. This is material world. And in the material world, whatever form we may have, we have got attachment for this body. Not only attachment, we are under the impression that I am this body. Everyone. That is material conception of life. So that thing happened to Arjuna in the battlefield. He identified himself as the body. He thought himself that he belongs to the Guru family, and his family relatives, his other side, his brother, nephews, or his grandfather. So he refused to fight. My dear Krishna, after placing the chariot between the two parties, Srinayor Ubhayor Madhye Ratasthapayame Achyuta. And then he became very much disturbed that I have to kill the other side, my brother and my nephews, my grandfather. No, Krishna, I cannot. This is not possible. I shall not fight. This is the stage of Bhagavad Gita. Krishna became very much dissatisfied. Of course, Arjuna played the part of a conditioned soul. A conditioned soul is under the impression that he is the body. That is animal life. In the Shastra, it is said, anyone who is identifying himself with this material body, he is animal. Gokhara. Saeva gokhara. Go means cows and khara means ass. Jasyatma buddhi kunapi tridhatuke sadhik kalatra disubhoma ijyadhi jatitha buddhi salile na karhiche janesu avigyesu saeva gokhara. Jasya, anyone who is identifying himself with this body, which is made of tridhatu. According to Ayurvedic medical system, this body is production of kapha, pitta, vayu. Or in our modern medical science, anatomy, physiology, This body is a combination of bones, muscles, skin, blood, urine, stool, that's all. So, Shastra says, if anyone thinks that he is this lump of bones, flesh, blood, urine and stool, jasya atma buddhi kunapi sridhati, and sadhik kalatradishu, and the production of this bones and flesh, kalatradishu, because we have got relationship here in this material world with wife, kalatra means wife, kalatra, kalatradishu, beginning from wife. Wife produces so many children, therefore adi, the beginning is wife. So, sadhik kalatradishu, the wife and my children, they are mine. Kith and kin, sadhik kalatra, sadhik, they are my own. Everyone is working. Even a great economist, Mr. Marshall, he says that economic development begins from family affection. Family affection. So, unless one thinks that he has to maintain his wife, children, family, there is no question of economic development. Impetus. So, jasyatma buddhi kunape tridhatuke sadhik kalatradishu and bhoma yujyadhi. Bhoma, this earth, as worshipable. Bhoma yujyadhi jatitha buddhi salile. And for pilgrimage, the one who thinks that the water is tirtha. Tirtha means where one can get transcendental knowledge. Sadhik kalatradishu bhoma yujyadhi jatitha buddhi salile na karhichir janesu abhigyesu. But has no interest to associate with persons who is expert in transcendental knowledge. Such these persons, they are called gokhara. Gokhara means cows and asses. So, Arjuna played the part of a gokha. In the battlefield of Kurukshetra, he played the part of an ordinary person, gokhara, who is identifying this body as self. Therefore, he required instruction. Not only he becomes so much overwhelmed that he gave up his arrows and bows and sat down tightly, "My dear Krishna, I cannot fight." And he was crying. Not only he gave up his duty, he was Kshatriya and he was crying, "Oh, I will have to kill my kinsman. No, I cannot do." So this is the setup in the first chapter of the Bhagavad Gita. This is the summary. Now, Sanjaya Uvacha. Sanjaya is speaking to Dhritarashtra. Sanjaya is seeing the battlefield within his heart. That is another television. And by the grace of Vyasadeva, he learned the art that he advanced. He was so much advanced that just like we see television relay from the battlefield, and he, Dhritarashtra was blind, and his secretary, Sanjaya, he was speaking. He was seeing the activities in the battlefield. Dhritarashtra inquired from him, "Dharma-chetre, Kuru-chetre, samabeta yudhushava, mamaka pandavaschaiva kimakur vata sanjaya." He was asking Sanjaya, what did they do? Kim akavata sanjaya? That was the question. And first of all, Sanjaya described the arrangement in the battlefield, and then he is speaking. Now, sometimes Bhagavad Gita is misinterpreted that this battle, I mean to say, dharma khetra kuru khetra means this war. We do not misinterpret in that way. There is no question of misinterpretation. We are presenting Bhagavad Gita as it is. We do not change by our whimsical imagination, concoction. We do not interpret the words of the Bhagavad Gita according to our own desire. No. Actually, from literary point of view, interpretation is required when things are not understood very clearly. Then interpretation required. In the law court, when the lawyers try to interpret before the judge, when the terms are not very clear, that is the same way in amongst the associates and society of learned scholars. Interpretation is not required when the things are very clear. Just like the sunlight. There is no need of a lamp to show the sun. The sun is self-effulgent. It is already there, light is there. Why one should take a lamp to show the sun? This misinterpretation has killed the spirit, the real essence of Bhagavad Gita. So there are so many reasons and so many misinterpretations. Our this Krishna consciousness movement, our proposition is that we are presenting Bhagavad Gita as it is. We do not misinterpret. So dharma khetra kuru khetra. Kurukshetra is dharma khetra, the place where religious ritualistic performances are done. Kurukshetre dharma machare, that is the Vedic verse. So Kurukshetra is always, still people go for pilgrimage in Kurukshetra, and the station is there, Kurukshetra, and the place is there, people go there, Kurukshetra. Why one should interpret that Kurukshetra means this body and Pandava means this Pancha Indriya, so many things. There is no question of interpretation. And this Mahabharata means the history of greater India. That is Mahabharata. History, it is history. It is not a fiction, it is history. Mahabharata. This planet was formerly known as Bharatvarsha. This planet, the whole planet. Not that the piece of land as we are calling now Bharatvarsha. No. Before that, this planet was known as Ilavati Varsha. And after the reign of Maharaj Bharat, the son of Rishabdev, this planet became Bharatvarsha. So Bharatvarsha means the whole planet. But we have lost, just like we have lost a portion of the present Bharatvarsha as Pakistan. Everyone knows, 20 years before, there is no such thing as Pakistan. But circumstantially, we have lost. So the whole Bharatvarsha has been partitioned, as this portion is called America, this portion is called Europe, this portion is called Asia. These are modern names. Actually, the whole planet was Bharatvarsha, and the whole planet was being controlled by Vedic culture. So, as we have lost our Vedic culture, as we could not control the others, other people in other parts of the world, by our culture, by our political maneuver, we have lost. Even after the day of battlefield of Kurukshetra, while Kurukshetra, up to the time of Maharaj Parikshit, the whole world was being controlled by one king in New Delhi, Hastinapur. There was no other king. And when the battlefield was there, all people from all parts of body, all parts of the world, they joined either this party or that party. That was the battlefield. So this is the picture of the battlefield of Kurukshetra, and Krishna is ordered by Arjuna to place the chariot in between the two soldiers. Now, after seeing the soldiers and the kings and other party, Arjuna is aggrieved, so much so that he did not like to fight and he was crying. Now, Dhritarashtra asked Sanjaya, then what happened next? Dhritarashtra was very much anxious. He said, Dharmakhetri Kurukhetri Samavita Yudhisthira. Now these two parties, Yudhisthira, they both of them were desirous of fighting, Yudhisthira. The one party is Mamaka, my sons, and the other party is Pandava, the sons of my brother Pandu. Mamaka Pandava Ashtaiva. Now the word is used, Yudhisthira. They assemble for fighting. Then what is the use of asking King Apurvata? Then what did they do? It is natural to conclude that when they assemble for fighting, there must be fight. But why he was asking King Apurvata? The suspect was that because the parties assemble in the Dharmakshetra, so they might have changed their ideas. Still, in India, if there is two fighting parties, they go to a temple and ask that you say the right thing. So in the temple, still in the villages, they do not dare to speak lies. Yes, they fighting and the misunderstanding become settled up. So, Dhritarashtra was thinking whether the two parties, they have settled up. He did not like that. He wanted that these Pandavas should be killed and my sons, Kauravas, they should come out victorious so that there will be no enemy. He was very much anxious to place his sons on the throne. Because he was blind, he could not acquire the throne. His younger brother was situated on the throne. Now, after the death of his younger brother, he thought that I missed the opportunity of sitting on the throne. Why not my sons? They have got actual right. That is the background of this Kurukshetra battle. He was always devising some means how the sons of Pandu, his nephews, could be separated and his sons would sit on the throne. That was his idea. Therefore he inquired, King Apurvata. Otherwise there is no question of inquiring King Apurvata. They went there to fight, they would fight there. But he was suspecting if they have made any compromise, that he did not like. That he didn't lie. Therefore he asked, he wanted that there must be fight. And there are five brothers, my sons are 100 in number. So they would be killed and my sons will be without any rivalry. This is the background of Kurukshetra. The another thing is, the effect of Dharmakshetra was visible in Arjuna. Dharmakshetra. He, because he is devotee of Krishna, jashasti bhakti bhagavati akanchana sarvai gunai tatra samasati siddha. because he is devotee of Krishna, therefore he felt, oh, what is this? Why should I kill this, my brother? Because he was devotee. This sentiment came into the mind of Arjuna, not on the other side, Duryodhana. He never thought. Although they are blessed, both of them blessed at Dharmakshetra, the effect of Dharmakshetra was manifest in the body of Arjuna, not Duryodhana. This is the... If one is pure, then the effects of dharma becomes manifest very quickly. Namang duskitina murha prabaddante naradhama. Krishna says, that those who are too much sinful, simply their life is sinful, duskritina. Duskritina, kriti. Kriti means one who has got good brain. But duskritina, but the brain is applied for mischievous activities. For mischievous activities, it also requires good brain. And similarly, for pious activities, that also requires brain. But those who are applying their brain for mischievous activities, they are called duskriti. So duskritina, namang duskritina mura. Why they do so? Because they are murha rascals. If one has got good brain, he should apply it for good work. But sometimes they are utilized, just like a thief. He has got good brain. A rogue, he has got good brain. But he is applying for mischievous activity, for making people unhappy. That is not the right use. Jnana khala. They are called jnana khala. One who has got nice knowledge, it should be utilized for better purpose. So, the effect of Kurukshetra, Dharmakshetra, was visible in the person of Arjuna, not in the person of Duryodhana. That is the difference. Therefore, he was crying. So, I am put in such a position that I have to fight and I have to kill my brothers, my nephews, my grandfather. He was too much affected. Although it is weakness, but it is not actually weakness, it is compassion. Arjuna was not a coward, neither he was less heroic than the other side, but out of compassion, because he was devotee. Devotee is there paradukha dukhi. The symptom of a devotee is they are unhappy by seeing others unhappy. That is the symptom of devotee. Generally, person, if he sees somebody happy, he becomes unhappy. Matsarata. That is the world situation. If I see my brother is very happy, he has improved in his material condition, then I become unhappy. He has advanced so much, and I could not do so. This is material situation. Materials are envious. Grihamedhi. Everyone is envious. Either you take person to person or neighbor to neighbor, their sympathy is lip sympathy. Actually, everyone is envious. Businessman to businessman, nation to nation. This is material work. Therefore, spiritual advancement means for person who is not envious. Not envious. Paramanirma sararang satang vastava vastu vidam. In the Srimad Bhagavatam we say that if you want to know the real truth, vastava vastu, the one must become paramanirmatsara. Nirmatsara. Matsar, matsar means envious, and nirmatsara, not envious, and parama, first class, nirmatsara. Therefore, Vyasadeva says, that dharma prodhita koitava atra parama nirmatsaranam. In the introduction of Srimad Bhagavatam, Vyasadeva says, who are the candidates to understand this science of God, Srimad Bhagavatam. It is not for the persons who are entangled in cheating religious system. Cheating dharma koitava. Koitava means cheating. So cheating type of religious system are kicked out from this book, Srimad Bhagavatam. But it is meant for persons who are not envious. Parama nirmatsaranam satam. Vastava mostu, one who wants to learn real reality, not false reality. Here in this material world, everything is false reality. Just like we are trying to find out water in the desert. That is the example, my day. False, there is no water. But the animal, he sees that there is water, fast water, and he runs after it and dies. So, here in this material also world, every one of us running after the false mirage, that there is happiness, there is happiness, there is happiness. This is called material condition. And we are envious. This is the position. And therefore, Krishna begins the Bhagavad Gita to get out of this ignorance and enviousness, and this is the basic principle of Bhagavad Gita. So, we shall discuss tomorrow again. Thank you very much.